I don't think you realise how well you've done with him. You'd have been a good father, Sam. I do think about that, you know. Now I know about you and Jane and the baby. Just wonder what things would have been like if only...
I can't start thinking about stuff like that.
If only Jane had been able to talk to me instead of Duncan, things would have been completely different.
It's not healthy, Natalie. You're thinking about what-ifs.
Why ever not? You're pregnant. How could you? How could this happen? Oh, it's all right, darling. You are quite right to tell me. And don't you worry, as I'm going to take care of absolutely everything.
When I told my mum and dad about Jane, they said they want nothing more to do with me.
They've gone and left you, Sam? Your own parents?
Yeah, they've moved to St Albans.
We were young parents too. It didn't do us any harm, did it? And Ryan being born out of wedlock, that didn't do him any harm either, eh?
This is our 15-year-old daughter we're talking about, Duncan. She's meek, she's unsullied, and medically speaking, she's still a virgin. And that's how we're going to treat her.
We're offering you the chance of a lifetime, Sam Armstrong. You'll never look back. This is the stuff that dreams are all about. What do you say?
Says yes. Don't you, Sam? This is Anka from the agency.
Hi. I like to meet some mothers before birth, if I'm going to spend a lot of time with their babies.
Hi.
I'll miss you.
I know, but it'll only be for one season, just until the wedding.
It's going to be a beautiful day. I'll make sure of it.
Could this be more perfect? Tomorrow I'm getting married to the man of my dreams. My first love. The father of my child, my wonderful baby. My perfect, adorable little baby. I don't get to see the baby much, but it's so well looked after. I suppose that's the main thing. Tomorrow my name will be Mrs. Sam Armstrong. Welcome to my life.
Oh, good morning, Lucy. Did you sleep well, darling? How about some breakfast?
I dreamt that we were still at our old house down the street and Sam was still at home.
I thought you'd like your new house in St Albans.
I do. It's great. It's got underfloor heating and everything. I thought Sam would be here. I mean, that's the reason I'm here, isn't it?
Got a point there, Lucy. Where is that brother of yours?
Sorry.
So, when do you get to play for the main team?
And is there like a members bar where you ain't letting the fit women?
It's not as glamorous as it sounds. Believe me, it's good to be home.
Have you seen Jane and the baby yet?
Well, I'm just about to. I thought I'd dump my stuff off here and get settled in.
They're only over the road. You can pop over any time.
He's got a really big chin like you have, Sam.
Evening. Nice of you to join us in daylight.
Don't give her a hard time. Well, I was up till really late doing her coursework. She's going to be a rocket scientist, this one.
Yeah, that's right. Hey, Sam.
Right. I've sorted out all the makeup that I'm going to use tomorrow, and I've got a little kit just in case I need to redo my face before the reception.
Oh, don't be silly, darling. Someone else will sort that out for you.
I like to do my own makeup.
It'll be wonderful seeing Sam again, won't it?
Yeah. But it's been such a long time.
Oh, there's no need to be nervous, darling. You are getting married, but nothing else need change. You can still live down here with me. Well, Sam's up in Newcastle. Be better for the baby.
Alex, there's a young man to see you here.
Hi, mate. Thanks for coming. Everybody, this is Josh. Oh, Josh, this is Roxanne, Will, Dennis, Della, Sam, and Lucy.
Look, in that one there, you can see Alan Shearer's elbow.
Oh, no way.
Josh works with me. He normally comes to the lockup.
Clearly, my dad didn't employ you because of your charm. But don't you think you should move out the way when someone's trying to get past?
It's a difficult time for him.
You have seen him naked, right? I mean, I kind of believe this whole virgin pregnancy thing, but you and Sam did at least fool around, right?
Well, it was dark. I didn't really see much. But I did touch him.
Well, that's something, I suppose.
And he touched me.
Did you like it?
Yeah, but it was such a long time ago.
You're getting married, Jane. You do know what happens on your wedding night, don't you? You really are scared, aren't you?
There is nothing to it. Nothing to be frightened of at all. Speaks the voice of experience. But isn't your first time meant to be like the most amazing thing ever?
Wow. You never know. With Sam, it could be.
I'd be more frightened of the hen night I've got set up.
What? I'm joking.
Oh, kind of.
You can't stay in here all day, mate. I'm going blotchy. Sam, when are you going to go around to the Harpers? See your wife to be and your kid.
Yeah, it's nice in here, though, isn't it?
Dad has already told Jane that you're back.
It's just I haven't seen her for so long. Maybe things won't be like they were.
But the baby, and you haven't even held it yet.
It just feels weird. I don't feel like a dad. I feel like I'm useless. Like I can't provide. Oh, you know.
You're a footballer, Sam. You're so not useless. You'll be earning millions before I've even got a paper out.
Yeah, right, Dennis. I'm a footballer. Everyone's gonna be hunky dory.
Oh, a bit less of an angle. Huh? Ah, I have taught you well, Grasshopper. Mm. You do the blades and the saws after that. So, what did you think of everyone this morning? I thought that maybe you and Dana could...
No offence, Mr. Rose, but she didn't seem that nice to me.
Oh, it's great to see you. Jane, see, Sam's here. Oh, the young family reunited, isn't that marvellous?
This is the baby.
Yeah, sorry you weren't at the birth. It was all such a panic. We just simply forgot to call. Sam. And it is such a long way from Newcastle.
My sister lives on the outskirts of St. Albans with a screaming baby. I live in elegant St. John's Wood, in glorious semi-retirement. In truth, I felt quite broody when I heard that Abby had become a mother again. I was so jealous. I felt almost happy when I heard she'd had a little car accident. But she escaped without a scratch. And then to learn that my nephew Sam had impregnated a 15-year-old girl. Well, it left a mark on me. But I will turn this familial disgrace to my advantage. It is my destiny to rear another child and instill in it a true sense of moral righteousness.
It's really nice to see you.
Yeah. You okay? Looks like Mum's got everything under control.
Yeah. But it's not quite how I imagined it.
Yeah, it's hard being alone, isn't it?
Look, I hate being alone too. And I know I've got my family and I know it's probably easier for me than it is for you. But sometimes I just really miss
being together.
I could come up with you.
after the wedding, we could move in together in Newcastle.
But, I mean, this is where you live. You can't leave here.
I bet you've got a really nice house up there. I mean, I've read all about footballers' lives. Really magical. Like a fairy tale.
Yeah, but your mum won't let you.
I wouldn't tell her. Don't you think it's weird how we've never actually done it properly?
We will. Tomorrow, I guess.
Can I see it? I mean, how can I marry you if I've never actually seen it?
Okay.
I love you, Sam.
I love you too.
So, what's Genius Boy up to?
Oh, I promised I'd help him work out the stag night. He's made the list, he wants to go over it. See if he's forgotten anything.
Well, if you get stuck for anywhere to hold it, you're always welcome here.
A bit classy for us, this place, Charlie. Besides, I'm sure Dennis has already got somewhere booked up. Hello. Are we going to see Mike later, then?
Oh, I don't know. Actually, I'm really worried about him, Alex. He's so stressed at work. I mean, he doesn't have any energy for anything else. He and Will, they're up for the same promotion.
Yeah, well... Will's a player, Fiona. He always gets what he wants. A man gets everything. I think you better prepare Mike for the worst. So, let's see this list of yours then.
I got stuck.
I can't believe Sam didn't mention you were coming. He told me all his family had disowned him.
Oh, they disowned me too, Dr. Harper. Samuel has just joined a rather exclusive club. He's well rid of them. Oh, it's beautiful. Aren't you? Yes, you are. Yes, you are. Oh, what facial features. So good to see my family genes have triumphed once again against the odds. No offence. You've done a marvellous job, Dr. Harper. Braving what must have been an absolute barrage of social disapproval. Everything looks perfect.
Well, the main thing is that she's well provided for.
Oh, yes.
Accommodation, clothing, full-time nanny, of course.
You seem in total control.
That's the least I can do for my daughter. It's all such an unfortunate business.
There's so much ugliness in the world, Dr. Harper. We must all do our best to shut it out.
24 beers in a case, 24 hours in a day. Coincidence? I think not. You're not off your beer, surely.
I haven't told Jane the truth.
What?
Well, I wasn't going to tell her. I didn't think I had to. And then she got this idea in her head. She wanted to come and live with me in Newcastle.
Oh, surely that's good.
It's not going too well. They're going to pass me on to another club. I'm not even sure it's third division.
Oh, what?
I thought I was going to make loads of money. I thought everything would work out, but how can it? I won't have enough money for me, let alone a wife and kid. I've messed up. I'm not what Jane thinks I am.
Oh, you'll be all right. I mean, if she loves you, then, well, that should be enough, shouldn't it?
Mum, can I talk to you?
Can you talk to me? What a question.
After the wedding, I want to leave college and move up to Newcastle with Sam.
What about your life here? Thought we'd sorted everything out.
Well, you know what it's like when you find someone that you want to spend the rest of your life with, and well, that's Sam. And that's all I want. Me, him, and the baby.
Jane.
I just know that we're going to spend a beautiful life together.
Jane! I'm sorry. I didn't mean to. All I meant to say, it's going to be fine. It's going to be fine. Because I'm in control now. You don't have to worry about anything.
So, and what's this I hear about promotion at work? You and Mike fighting it out?
Your sources are out of date, Alex. I've already got the promotion.
Yeah, but Mike doesn't know, so don't tell him, all right?
Well, that's nice. What sort of friend does that make me?
Sometimes, Alex, it's best not to know the truth. Ignorance is bliss.
It's all gone wrong. Again, I tried all the places you told me, but they're all booked up. Apparently I should have tried sooner, like the day before or something.
You don't think it might look a bit cheap?
Mother, you are going on a hen night organised by Della Wells. You'll fit in perfectly.
Oh, I do hope she's chosen somewhere appropriate for Jane. Ryan, would you mind just nipping up and getting that scarf off the bed? I just want to see if it goes.
In England, it is usual that the mother goes on the daughter's stag night. Where I come from, many daughters wish their mothers do not attend.
Oh, really?
Oh, yes. Often there is naked man. But I think this is everywhere usual.
Oh. Oh, well, I have to go. Just to take care of her.
Oh. I look after her baby. You look after yours.
Yes. Anka, I know that tomorrow is officially your day off.
You like me to look after baby? You like me to come to wedding? I have a hat I brought.
Well, actually, I'd prefer it if you looked after it here. It's just that I don't really want Jane worrying about the baby when, well, she really should be focusing on Sam.
She did the same to me, you know. She thought I might cry in church. My mother, she left me with a babysitter while she married my father. How refreshing to see history repeating itself, Mother.
I read the ban in the local paper, so I thought I'd show my face. I hear your parents have disowned you. Oh, you must feel terrible.
They haven't disowned him, they're just a bit angry. Now, why are you here and what do you want?
I don't want anything, young lady. But as I'm here, I dare say I could lend my support at the wedding. After all, you'll need somebody to sit on the groom's side in the church.
He's got me.
Look, come on, Lucy. I'm sure Aunt Rachel isn't here to cause trouble. Look, of course she can. I'll be honoured.
Oh, I must make haste to the nearest purveyor of fine hats. Nice to see you again. Both of you.
She's up to something, Sam. Don't be a dunce.
Oh, she's being nice.
I know she doesn't like me seeing him.
What, Natalie doesn't like Sam?
Doesn't think he's good enough for me or something. She pretends otherwise, but I can tell.
Natalie Harper? Well, I never.
What do you think of this hair?
Yeah, that's great.
Della did it. I think it looks tarty.
Tarty?
Would you mind who Della married?
Well, I guess all dads are the same, aren't they? No one's good enough for my little princess.
Have you met any of her boyfriends?
No, I mean, I don't think she's met anyone yet. You know, she's so busy with school and work and everything.
Is that what she tells you? Ah, there you are. I was about to give up on you. Shh. If anyone asks, we weren't here.
Entertainment.
Entertainment. Now, you do know what I mean by that, don't you, Dennis? I just don't want Sam to miss out on any of the stag experience. You know, kissograms.
No. No, I didn't think of that. But he wouldn't want that, would he? Well, he's not that sort of bloke. Well, not anymore.
Well, he was before he met my daughter, and I'm sure he's still got a little bit of the stud left in him.
You seem to know him better than I do. Maybe you should come along for the stag night.
Oh, no, no, I can't possibly. I've got to go to the hen night.
You sure that's cool with Della?
Well, I don't care if it is or not. I'm certainly not leaving my daughter alone with her on the night before the most important day of her life. Oh, one of my patients, I think, is a kissogram. Maybe I could give her a ring.
Oh, no, I mean, I should do it, really. Just give me her number.
Oh, no, 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 no. Patient confidentiality, you know. Hippocrates would be turning in his grave. And I'm sure you're really fed up anyway with having to organise absolutely everything. All the time.
You know they say true love's indestructible. I mean, anything can happen and the love won't stop. Do you believe that?
Yeah, I guess so. I mean, it sounds nice.
You know, I love you truly, madly, a lot.
I love you more than a lot. What this one?
If that was you, I'd still love you. I wouldn't mind what you look like. I'd still love you. I'd still love you if you're the poorest person in the world.
Oh.
But it's not going so well. The football.
Newcastle don't really want me anymore and, well, they're going to pass me on. I wanted to buy you diamonds.
I don't care about diamonds, Sam. I thought you were going to tell me that you've been unfaithful or something. Money means nothing to me. All I want is you.
I love you.
Yeah, sorry not to be more sociable. It's just all this has got to be in by tomorrow morning. Yeah, I think I've got a real chance for this promotion. And if I get it, we're going to have a nice long holiday. Just you and me, eh?
Do you think it's all worth it, Mike? I mean, it seems like a lot of work for nothing.
Oh, it's not for nothing, Alex. Will, he's been a real smart ass recently. And just for once, I'm going to show him I don't always come off second best.
He is second best.
I know. Roxy called.
And you haven't told Mike?
I haven't got the heart. He's put so much into it. He's put this marriage into it. And all for nothing.
I spoke to Samuel. He seemed quite wary of me at first, but I think I won his trust. Not the brightest child, is he?
I must admit that thought had crossed my mind.
Don't be shy, Dr. Harper. I take no offence. He gets it all from his barrow boy father. Nothing to do with my bloodline.
He's stupid and he's not good enough for my daughter.
There, there. Oh. Now it's in the open, we can move on.
I'm going to split them up.
Very good. How?
We have some of Sam's old things in the attic. Some of his old books and his old toys and his old phone numbers.
Intriguing. Go on.
Girls he used to know. I phoned them up and some of them were unemployed. Oh. So I offered them money to come tonight and be his kissogram.
And you will engineer for Jane to be watching when the fireworks go off.
Absolutely.
Oh, there'll be oohs and ahs aplenty. Genius. But there is the small matter of the baby. Possibly it is an eyesore for you.
It's just that Jane is so very busy at the moment. And, well, if she wants to go to medical school, as she says she does.
Out of sight, out of mind.
Now, it's not that we don't love it. I'm sure we could come to...
financial arrangement.
For you to...
take it away.
How much shall we say? I see you are willing to pay to take it away.
What a turn.
Are we...
evil? Yes, Dr. Harper. That's what we are. Oh, I guess we've all got stuff in the back of our minds that we know that we just choose to ignore. Like I know that I don't love Mike anymore. I don't. I don't love him.
As soon as Nat told me Jane was having a baby, made me reevaluate my entire life. Nearly packed my job in. I said to Will we should quit, set up our own business, actually do something with the rest of our lives. He told me we had good jobs and we'd be idiots to leave them. It's best to stick with what you know, I think. Nice job. Nice kid. Nice wife. Nice life. Sometimes I think there's something in me that wants change, but I can't quite work out what it is.
Look, I thought you said a load of your friends were coming.
Yeah, well, I guess they just made other plans.
It's not much of a party, is it?
Well, you have kind of cut yourself off from the world recently. I mean, do you even have any friends apart from me? You're lucky I could even spare the time.
chirp and chirp so brightly. My, how it looked the lawn. I lifted up the window. It gave me a little peck. And so I pulled the window down and broke its blooming neck.
Sam Armstrong. Sorry for interrupting. Alex said I should come. He invited me.
You're Josh, right? You work with him? Well, take a seat. I'm not sure where Alex is, but I'm sure Grace is with his presence eventually.
Right. You want a drink, Sam?
Yeah. Milk, please.
Milk? Glass of milk, please, Django. So, where are you off to tonight, you lads?
Oh, actually, we're just going to stay here, Charlie, if that's all right.
On a stag?
Yeah, it's all right, Charlie. I don't want any lap dances or anything. Not now I'm marrying Jane. The sooner I get a bed, the sooner I wake up, and the sooner I get married. You get dressed and hurry.
I thought you said that this was ladies' night.
It is.
Then why are the gentlemen in the toilets? What sort of a debauched place is this?
No! You two really have to chill. I'm sure Sam's getting up to much worse. Think of it, getting even in advance.
No, he wouldn't.
No, of course not. He's probably just down the pub having a quiet drink with his mates.
Don't you listen to her, darling. I know Sam very well, and he would never, ever look at another woman.
Just making conversation. Are you gonna shake your stuff tonight?
Mike, I thought you were working late. Oh, don't tell me they've promoted you already.
No. No, it will. Apparently they've known about that all week. Just never thought it was important to tell me about it.
So the sorrows are gonna get well and truly drowned?
No, I bet Will knew about it. Been watching me all week, breaking my back, preparing that presentation.
Told your wife yet?
I can't find her. Spends a whole month telling me I'm never there, and then the one night I need her, she's gone.
Are you on your way? Yes? Good. Well, it's the Nautilus, that's right. Yes, it's a grimy little place. You can't miss it. I do not want you dressed as anything strange. No traffic wardens or police women. You must look like a normal person. Yes. Stranger in the night. And, don't do anything until you get my text message. Right, good. Goodbye. Right. Come on, Jane. I think we should leave here. This is not the place for us. We should go and have a nice, quiet drink. How about the Nautilus? Come on. Good idea. Here we go.
At last, I thought they'd never leave. Now, did you say your name was again? Actually, tell me in the morning.
Oh, my word. Look, you just sit down there. Let's not disturb them. We better not.
Yeah, one for you.
Debbie?
What, it was just...
He's a footballer. You do know what that means, don't you?
Of course she doesn't want it, Sam. She's 16. She's got a whole life ahead of her.
But he said I was all that mattered. Me and the baby.
She begged your Aunt Rachel to take it away. She even considered paying her.
Oh, I hate to be the one to say this to you, but Samuel... He asked me to look after the baby. Permanently.
She didn't even want to take it to the wedding tomorrow. She was going to leave it at home. Imagine, Sam.
He doesn't want it, Jane. He never did.
Life is full of disappointments, Sam. You really should get used to that.
Perhaps his kissing the other girl was just his way of telling you.
What now?
Come on, Faye.
You know, in less than 3 hours we could be in Paris. Or Rome. Why not?
Because my life's here.
Won't you at least let me try and change your mind?
I can explain, honest I can. You can't just give up on me. You're all I want, you're all I've got. I don't care about anything else. Nothing else matters apart from you and me. Just you and me, Jane, come on.
The traffic can't be that bad. Well, why were you so late setting off in the first place? Oh, Duncan, I do despair sometimes. Well, look, there's nothing more to discuss. I'll see you later. Goodbye.
You didn't think to tell him the winning's off, then?
He can wait till he's home and find out soon enough. Let him stew a bit.
You really are a witch, aren't you, Mother? It's quite extraordinary. But a happy witch. You know, your spell has worked. You're over the moon that Jane's dumped Sam. And now she's all yours again.
I'm only doing what's best for her, you know. That's all.
I'm Celeste, the beautician, for your daughter's wedding.
Oh, yes, of course. Well, I'm afraid there's nothing for you to do because the wedding's off. Yes, my daughter was up half the night crying because her fiancé was unfaithful.
To save a wasted journey, how about you give me a facial?
Jane's getting married today. I always thought I'd be the one to settle down before her, have a normal family and stuff. She'd be the one going off doing something exciting. In a way, she was always more confident than me. Then that sperm thing with Sam happened and it all changed. Now she's this virgin bride with a baby. And I'm not. Losing it on your wedding night, how weird would that be? Anyway, I'm a grown-up. More grown-up than Jane. Sort of. Sometimes I think Mum's jealous of me. She thinks I'm too wild or something. She almost killed me when she saw this. Wonder what she'd say if she knew about the others.
Jane! Jane, are you awake, darling?
Oh, she's gone.
She's flown the nest with the golden egg. How could you let this happen, Dr. Harper?
Well, I tried to keep an eye on her.
No, not good enough.
It's not my fault. I was doing so well.
Was in the past tense is no good for the here and now. Now, come on, Dr. Harper. We have got to get to work. Whatever your daughter is planning must be sat on.
You know, princesses as sweet as you should not cry.
I can't help it.
You wouldn't cry if you didn't love him.
I thought he was perfect. But then I saw him with another girl, an old flame of his. They knew each other and he kissed her.
See, it doesn't mean a thing. Your mum, she set Sam up. She hired the girl and she made sure that you saw.
No.
Speak to him. He's waiting for you at the halfway house.
She's gone, I tell you, gone. Is this Chief Inspector Doyle? Yes, I thought as much. Well, she has gone, I tell you. She has gone and she has taken my grandson. They've been kidnapped. Yes, they've been kidnapped by Sam Armstrong. He has kidnapped them and he is going to kill them. They put me on hold. How could they do that? It's important.
They probably just dropped the phone and came right over.
Oh, I'm so glad you're here. Thank you so much. I'm terrified something dreadful has happened.
Well, we'd have to work a price out first, love. I mean, I'm only down for going to the church in Peck.
She could be anywhere, but yes, you're right. She could be hiding out at the church. Eddie?
Natalie Brake? What's going on here?
Are you a policeman?
No, I'm a driver.
For the police?
No, for weddings. I'm here to take a Miss Jane Arbour down to church. So how are you keeping?
Brazil.
Buenos Aires. Correct. Buenos Aires, it is.
Sorry I didn't let you in last night.
I don't blame you.
What is the currency of the gang?
Run away with me.
You know, if they blindfolded me and hid you in the world someplace, I'd find you. And if I couldn't find you, I'd find someone else and tell them about you.
You stole that from a film.
Jane.
I'm sorry.
Isn't it unlucky to see each other? Or does this mean there's no wedding?
I want it to be just us. No one else.
Just you and me, really?
In 90 minutes we could still be married. If that's what you want.
Well, well, well. It's Bonnie and Clyde. Hiding in the outback. Outrageous. Get away from the girl. The police are on the way.
The police?
You're a missing girl, Jane. You don't think your mother would let you disappear just like that. You come with me, girl. And you go back to Newcastle. Keep your head low. I'll try and smooth things over with the authorities.
Meet me at the altar. I love him more than anything.
I just can't bear the thought of him being unfaithful to you, Jane.
And when you've quite finished with my brother, I'd like you to make me out, please.
There is no time. We have 18 minutes. And who's going to give you away? Your father's refused to come, and so's the babysitter. Who's going to look after the baby?
And could you get the car started, please? We'll be leaving soon.
This wedding is such a bad idea. I always thought it was. Sam hasn't changed. He hasn't grown up at all. He proved that last night. He will ruin you, Jane.
Like Duncan's ruined you? Well, this is what it's about, isn't it?
I just don't want you to make the same mistakes that I did.
I'm going to the church. You coming or not?
I warned you, Samuel. I warned you to go back north. The police, Samuel. Dr. Harper is quite ready to press charges.
You're just trying to scare us. It's not illegal for us to be together. There's nothing you can do about it.
I knew you'd be like this. You're just as stubborn as your mother. But don't think that Jane will turn up at the aisle. Dr. Harper will see to that.
Jane said she'll be there, and I trust her. Anyway, why are you wearing black?
I am in mourning for your young life. The baby will ruin you. Jane doesn't want it.
The thing is, Aunt Rachel, I love her. Simple as that, and nothing else matters.
Love has often been compared to a beautiful flower bursting into bloom. Oh, let us hope that, like a flower, it doesn't fade, wither, and die.
Alex! Alex, get in. Get in the car.
What?
We've got a wedding to go to.
Nat, look, I'm sorry, but...
Jane needs you there.
Now, look, this is very sweet.
Duncan's done a Duncan. He's stuck on the M6. I want you to give my daughter away. Alex, I need you. Jane and I need you.
Do you?
We do.
Come on then.
She'll turn up. What she said earlier about it just being me and her. And that's all.
Okay, that's a good sign.
When she said me and her, I guess what she meant was just the two of us without the baby. That must have been what she meant, right? Well, there's worse things in the world than someone else looking after him. And there's loads of people out there crying out for a baby. And the bottom line is, I'd do anything for her because I love her. I mean, it's probably best if he does go to a proper home with someone else, someone who is cut out with all that sort of stuff. All that responsibility. And what do you think?
Honestly, mate, I'm the last person to ask. I am the best man, but not for that kind of advice.
Yeah, you just supply the rings, right? It's my future that hangs in the balance.
Dearly beloved, we have come together in the presence of God to witness and bless the joining together of this man and this woman in holy matrimony. The wedding ring is the outward and visible sign of an inward and spiritual bond which unites two loyal hearts in endless love. Jane Isolde Harper, do you take this man, Sam Benjamin Armstrong, to be your wedded husband?
I do.
Then I declare you man and wife. You may kiss the bride. Now please follow me to sign the register to make this bond of marriage legal.
Oh, Samuel, you might think this is the best day of your life, but for the rest of us...
Will we see you again, Sam?
Of course you will, Luce. When you're older and Mum and Dad don't hate me so much. Well then, Sam, how about a photo of you and your aunt?
Oh, Samuel, what has happened? Once cock of the roost. Now just one of mankind's battery hens.
And smile!
Lucy, stop! Are you okay?
It was a lovely service.
Is that why you're upset?
I don't want you to take him away from me, Jane. He's just my brother. I know he loves you, but he's not supposed to be married. He's supposed to be at home with us, with me. He'd never cope looking after a family. It's not Sam.
You speak a lot of sense for a 10-year-old.
I'm 11.
You'll look after your brother for me, won't you? Steph, what are you doing here? It's been 20 years.
I read it in the paper.
What paper? Have you been spying on us?
Oh, come on now, don't be ridiculous. I saw Jane's picture. I wanted to see you.
Jane, how did you know she was my daughter? It's Jane Harper. You don't even know I was married.
Come on, sis.
Well, don't you stand up for her, mate. You're like all the rest of the men around here, just weak.
She's not here to hurt me.
How do you know?
Mike, I'm sorry. Fiona said you needed me, and I've been such a bad sister.
It's all right. Fiona was there for me. I've sorted everything out now. It's all going to be okay.
We're going to have another baby.
Mother, you all right? You look a little peaky. Do you want your medicine now?
I don't understand. Why are you all here?
Drink up, Mother. We don't want to see.
This is my day. It's my special day. It's mine.
I know why you're here, Steph.
Where were
you. Smile.
Disappeared.
You didn't see where I went?
What?
You didn't see?
No.
Where's Lucy, Sam? Being a father is a big job, you know.
What kind of a sick joke is this?
The marriage is void, Sam. It would never have worked.
Jane, what does this mean?
How did I think that everything was going to be okay? You never wanted this baby. Either of you.
Oh, came as soon as I could. Oh, must have gone through umpteen speed cameras. Probably got myself a ticket.
Duncan, do you think I care about your journey here?
No. Late for my own daughter's wedding. Simply unforgivable.
Yes, it is, especially as everything else is falling apart around our ears. Jane has run off with the baby.
What? How? I had no idea.
I suppose I would have blamed you for all of this at one point, Duncan, but now I suddenly realise I don't care. And I haven't missed you, not one bit.
I don't understand.
It's time that I was the absentee parent, Duncan. It's my turn, and I am divorcing you.
Natalie! This is the last we'll see of you.
All I know is I've got to get away from here.
Who said that starting again will be easier than carrying on?
At least I can start again where nobody will interfere. I can have a real choice. First real choice I'll ever get to make in my life.
She's gone. You never find her.
She doesn't have the guts. Not on her own. No her.
Do you? Can I walk you home?
We're strangers.
Why do you think I'm asking?
Isn't it, you know, when people imagine what might have been, we always look at it like through rose-coloured spectacles. It's always, oh, wouldn't it have been brilliant if...
Maybe we would have let Jane down anyway.
Yeah, well, there's no point in speculating, is there? It's not going to happen.
Yeah, who knows how we would have acted. If we were the same people as we are now, then why wouldn't we be OK?
And we're doing all right now, aren't we?
Right.
So we can just carry on as we are.
Just as we are.